Thank you so much for choosing to watch today's video. I've got something really awesome that I want to show you. It's a brand new tool that I've been using in my training, and I think you're going to love it when you see what it is. So stick around for today's video and find out what it is that I'm talking about. What's up, everybody? Welcome back to another episode of Excellence in Motion. Yes, I sound like a toad. My allergies are kicking in super, super hard, so bear with me as I talk through some of this stuff today. If I make weird noises or you hear me,
oh, you gotta be shitting me.
That's why. But before we get started, I wanna give a big thanks and shout out to today's sponsor of the video, Train. I love wearing Train stuff. I think the apparel, the shorts, the shirts, the hoodies, all the stuff, super, super high quality. They've been to lots of our competitions and events, and they've been so gracious enough to allow me to be someone who can speak for them and collaborate with them to create cool stuff for you guys. So if you wanna get some of the cool gear that I get to wear when I'm around work or the gym, just go ahead and go down to the link in description. You can use the code below to get yourself some cool stuff. Now, with that out of the way, I think you probably have already guessed a little bit of what we're gonna be talking about today. If not by the title, then definitely by that intro. And it's the Airwave mouthpiece. The Airwave mouthpiece is a really interesting little piece of equipment. If you have been following anybody in the CrossFit space recently, you probably noticed Rich Froning, specifically at the games, chewing on some mouth guard. And it's a device that's been studied, researched, and proven to be effective for improving your cardiorespiratory endurance by just putting a little mouth guard inside of your mouth.
Oh, okay, goddamn.
This little thing right here is the, this little tiny thing right here, this is the Airwave mouthpiece. It's super, super tiny. It molds to your teeth. And what's cool about it is it's actually a bottom fit mouthpiece instead of a top fit mouthpiece. And there's some big reasons behind that. Based on the research that was produced when developing this product, and I'll link that in the description below for you to read if you want to, using this mouth guard in a way that promotes the lower jaw moving forward actually increases the airway opening by about 9%, decreases your respiratory rate by about 20%, and in doing so, allows for better flow of air and better recovery after long workouts. Decreases in cortisol levels have been shown to be about 50% with using this mouth guard when you're working out, which is super huge for recovery because cortisol is a huge stress hormone. Now we're stressed out. So the lower amounts of cortisol you have in your system, the lower your respiration rate, the better it is for you in your workouts to get the most out of it and to recover afterwards. I swear, guys, between takes, I'm literally just unrolling toilet paper from work to blow my nose. This is getting ridiculous. Another one of the cool things that I like about this mouthpiece is that it comes with a hard shell carrying case. The last thing you want is to be throwing something that goes into your mouth into your bag all willy-nilly, so you need something to carry it in. And they give you a nice hard shell case that has little vents on the top to sort of let some of that air flow through and it doesn't stay moist and wet all the time. So that's been a really cool addition. I just keep it in my gym bag, pull it out when I wanna use it, and I'm off and I'm ready to go. I wanna be quite upfront and frank with you. This is not an in-depth review of the mouthguard itself. It's more or less kind of a real world look at what it's been like using the product and my own personal perspective on it. I've been using the Airwave mouthpiece for probably 2 to 3 weeks at this point. And at first it was something really different and hard for me to get used to. You fit the mouthpiece with heating and water and all this kind of stuff, and you kind of have to mold it to your bottom teeth. But once it's fit, the way that it goes in allows for this little crossbar to sit just behind your bottom teeth as a way for you to latch the top of your tongue on and open up the airway. The thickness of the back grooves on the mouthpiece allow your jaw to scoot forward a little bit, and it also provides a little bit of a clenching thing for people who tend to clench when they do workouts. It was really, really weird and difficult to get used to using in a workout to start because I'm not used to having something in my mouth.
That's what she said.
And I actually got really, really dry through my mouth, so I was swigging water pretty consistently to try to keep my mouth a little bit more lubricated. But overall, the mouth guard took about 1 or 2 workouts to get used to. And then after that, things really started to settle in and I started to see a little bit of the benefits of using this thing. When the mouth guard is in, it really does force me to push my jaw forward and sort of rest the tongue on the backside, which brings in a lot of air through my airway and I definitely don't feel like I'm breathing heavily or more rapidly when I'm working out. So if you're in CrossFit or you're in any other type of workout regimen and you want to use something to try to improve your recovery and improve your cardiorespiratory endurance, this might be something worth trying. As a PT and as a coach, I'm all about trying new stuff, especially if it's something that you think is gonna help you in your fitness journey. So if you wanna pick up one of these, it's stupid cheap. I think it's like $39 is what it was when I purchased it. And I used a code from someone else on a podcast that I had heard, saved a little bit of money there. So you can get this for relatively cheap. It's definitely worth trying out to see if you like it or not. I definitely enjoy it and I think I'm gonna keep using it from here on out.
And at the very least, if you don't like it, you can walk around with it hanging out of your mouth like this and look like a total badass at the gym. Or you can just be one of those weird people that keeps it in your mouth all the time and always talks with it on and makes people know that you're doing something different that they're not doing so that you can be fitter than they are.
No, but in all honesty, I think it's totally worth the investment, at least to try and do some research on your own. Take my words for what they are. It's not total research. This is really just a real-world experiential review of the piece itself. I'm kind of late to the game, but that's totally fine. This is my view. I encourage you to go out and try one if you want to try one for yourself. Hopefully you guys enjoyed today's video. If there are any other products you want me to review for you, just let me know. I've got one that's coming up here in the next couple of weeks that I'm super excited to review for everybody, so stay tuned for that. If you want to see more videos like this one, please be sure to click on this little box over here. And until next time, go out, do good things, and don't forget to move. I'll see you guys in next week's video.